Namaste, the people in Mumbai, the people in New Delhi. Muli mutye mwasibireje agandi, mutye nye nedi. Muli omutye, all the people in Busia. Muna sema je Kenyans, welcome to Culture Connect. It's me, your girl Sharon today. And today I traveled all the way to Asia and I landed in India, yes. Some of you may be wondering why I'm wearing this. I'm looking so smart, so beautiful. Yes, I landed in India and I got a sari. A sari now. A sari, it's a traditional wear, yes, for Indians. And it's usually done by the women there in India. Yes, most women do saris. It's an unstitched cloth. It's easy and comfortable to wear. As you can see, I also managed to get one for myself. You guys can also get one for yourself. But for men, they usually do something called a sawani, as you can see up there. A sawani. But for women, yes. Looks so beautiful, so easy. It's so colorful and nice. And I'm so comfortable in it. Moving away from that now, Indians, the way they greet us, as you had my introduction, I was like, Namaste. Yes, I still do Namaste. Namaste simply means I bow down. Yes, I bow down to all of you, the people joining me, people have been following me. I love you so much. The people in Mumbai, New Delhi, Namaste. Yes, I love you. I love you so, 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 so much. Now in India, moving away from the dress code, we have the worship. The way they worship us. We have many religions in India, yes. We have the Muslims, we have the Christians, we have the Hindus. Those are the Indians, yes. Now, Indians, for them, they have many gods. You know, they have many gods that they worship. They have Lord Ganesha, whom they believe is the removal of obstacles. Then they have Krishna. For them, they believe Krishna is the protector of the cow. And a cow in India, oh my God. If you ever go to India and it's not a cow, it's not acceptable. It's not right to slaughter a cow or eat cow's meat. A cow actually, it's considered as Mother Earth. They believe it gives back to the earth. They worship it. The cow is usually actually decorated with beautiful colors, many colors. They worship it and they adore it. And giving back to a cow's shelter or contributing to building a cow's shelter is so important in India. Yes, moving away from all that, Indians, of course, they also do marriages. And they have arranged marriages. Their marriages actually two families. For example, the man's family, the girl's family. They have daughters, they have boys who have grown up, they want to marry. So what they do, they arrange a marriage for their children in India. And usually for, if it's a royal family, the girl's family arranges a party, then invites all the men who would wish to marry their daughter to come in. And then the girl chooses who to go with. The girl just chooses who to go with, but they still do the bride price, yes. But in some parts of India, yes, it's the girl who pays bride price, and it pays highly. Bride price, just imagine, it's the lady to pay the bride price, and they believe that the lady pays the bride price for the virginity of the man. The man is still a virgin. Yes, the lady has to pay the bride price. Now, I'll move away from that. The families, the way they live in very big and large white houses. They love living with their relatives, mother, daughter, grandchildren, everyone. They love living together. They love living together. And the houses are usually, the sitting rooms are wide and big, so that they can accommodate each and everyone. And they believe this helps them to relieve stress and pressure living with all their relatives. For example, if you have three boys in your family, in your house, you have three boys, they all marry. They have to bring all their wives into and stay with your parents. So it's the girl's family who always have to come and visit their daughter, which is also okay and very, very good. Now, Indians also do fasting, as Muslims do, Christians do. Hindus also do fasting. They believe that fasting, they pay gratitude and reverence to their gods. So they do fasting, which is also okay. It's very nice. For their food, they love rice and wheat, and they're also vegetarians and non-vegetarians in India. And they also, actually, another secret, they love eating with hands. In some parts of India, yes, usually the east and south of India, they love eating with their hands. Your hands have to be washed very clean, and then you eat with your hands. But for the north and west, they love spoons. They love eating with spoons, yes. But south and east, they do hands, which is very nice. Actually, it's a sign of unity. Like here in Africa, it's a sign of unity. And if they also do it, it's very good. Now, something I've been wanting to tell you guys something. The festivals. Indians have beautiful festivals. They have like the festival, the Diwali. Oh my God. The Diwali. This festival is celebrated for 5 days. Just imagine. A celebration for 5 consecutive days when you're celebrating. Oh my God. It's so nice. It's so nice and so great. And clear lanterns are usually lit across the city, all around the city. Usually New Delhi, they are lit across the city. And people are dancing. People are celebrating. People are giving away gifts. They believe that this celebration is a triumph of light over darkness. So they celebrate it for 5 days. All your relatives, family, children gather together. And actually this year's celebration, Diwali, will be from the 12th of November to the 16th of November. So if you can, make it there. Make it to New Delhi and you join these people in their celebration. It's so nice. The clear lanterns are lit all over the city and for 5 days you're celebrating. It's very nice. Now we also have some other festival that it's called the Holi. It's also called the Festival of Color. You've seen this Indian throwing colors to each other, blue, yellow, orange. Oh my God, it's so nice. They believe that on the they celebrate this to mark the demon. There's a demon called Holika who has overcome. So they celebrate to mark his death. They celebrate, they dance, they sing, they shout. You know that they dance.
Come on.